expectancy to be filled up with joy, expectant for breakthrough, expectant for a worshipful experience. So, enough of me. Before we continue, I want to pray. So everyone, just bow your heads, close your eyes. Dear Heavenly Father, I just thank you so much for every person in this room. I just ask that you help these kids to sing with all of their hearts. And I hope that you fill up every person with your joy tonight. And all of God's children say, amen. Amen. So we are beyond proud of this group of kids. So help me welcome the Capital Kids Choir, giving you a jolly Irish Christmas.
Well, Gia Gwich, lads and lassies, ladies and gents. Hi, Gia Gwich. That's an old Irish greeting. That simply means God be with you. And I'm Declan Patrick O'Connor. I'm an Irish bard, or as you might say, a storyteller. I'm here at his ancient ruins because I have an ancient story to tell. That is the true story of Christmas, as was told to me by my ancestors, who were told by their ancestors, who first heard it from the saints themselves, me namesakes, Patrick and Declan. Nollag Hanagwich to you all. Aye, Nollag Hanagwich. That's how we say Merry Christmas on the Emerald Isle. Now you go on and give it a try. Nollag Hanagwich.
Nollag Hanagwich.
That wasn't too bad. Now all of you look at your friends, turn to a neighbour, perhaps a stranger, and you try giving a proper Christmas greeting. Nollag
Hanagwich.
Oh, I heard them, but not out there. Let's try that one more time. Nollag
Hanagwich.
Oh, you're all proper Irish folk now. Oh, now do you know, at the Irish, we love music. We'll play a penny whistle, we'll dance a jig, or we'll sing a Celtic tune any chance we get. But do you know our favourite time of year for music?
Christmas!
That's right. We're going to have a jolly time together because Christmas Day is the Saviour's Day.
Flame in my heart that'll never grow cold. Today is a Savior's
Nalig Hanagwich, young lads and lassies, Merry Christmas.
Nalig Hanagwich!
Please, sir, tell us a story.
Please, please!
I keep your jumpers on. Oh, let me think. Once upon a time, there were three wee bunnies, Flopsy, Mopsy, and Peach.
No,
not that one!
Tell us the story of Christmas.
Settle yourselves down and I'll tell it. But you might have to help me remember a thing or two. Oh, let's see. It all started with a young lass, a wee babe, and the brave man who loved him. That young man, his name was Joseph. He had a very sticky problem, you see. He was engaged to marry the teenage lassie. Oh, she was a good girl. Lovely. Oh, she loved to worship on the holy days. She was always kind, and her gentle smile, it lit a warm spot right in the center of his heart. But there was a problem, and it was this. The teenage lassie, her name was Mary. She was pregnant, but the babe was not his. Aye, Joseph had a choice to make. Mary had told Joseph that she had been visited by an angel, the angel Gabriel. The angel told her not to be afraid, but angels, they can be very scary when they just show up like that. He told her that she would have a wee babe. His name would be Jesus, and he would be the son of the Most High God. He told her again not to be afraid, and she was doing her best to hold it all together. Oh, but Mary, she was just concerned of the logistics of the whole thing. But the angel told her that nothing would be impossible with God. Aye, Mary had a choice to make.
What did they do?
Yeah, what did they do?
Well, Mary and Joseph, they chose to obey God. It wasn't easy. Some folks say that it takes a town to raise a child. Well, just try telling that town that the child would grow up to be the son of the Most High God and the Savior of the world. And Mary, still a virgin.
Oh, no!
And if that wasn't enough, the IRS of the day, they told Joseph he had to take his family on a long journey just before the babe was to be born. Oh, it was rough going for Mary, riding that donkey all the way to Bethlehem during her labor. Oh, but a bright star, it lit their way. And even though all of the hotels were booked, they still found a place in the clean hay of a barn. And it was there that a little child was born.
Brown neon of the
Aye. Every time that a child is born, the noise of the world has to fade. As parents gaze into the eyes of a wiggling little miracle, nothing has the power to pull them away. The awe, the wonder, the peace after the pain, and the promise of a brand new future. Mary and Joseph, they were those kinds of parents. Why, if Joseph had a smartphone back then, oh, the internet would have been flooded with his pictures. But nothing but a little cricket in the corner of the barn would interrupt the silence of that sacred moment.
My mama had a baby, my little sister. She wasn't silent at all. She was loud!
Oh, doubt you, child. It wouldn't be silent in that barn for Mary and Joseph for very long either. They were about to expect some very excited visitors. Shepherds came bustling in from the nearby fields, jumping for joy and shouting all at once. It would take a moment for Joseph to get things sorted until things would calm down a bit. And as Mary wrapped the wee babe in the soft lambskins that they brought for him to snuggle into, the visitors, they told an amazing story about angels in the sky.
Angels?
Real live angels?
Like they have in heaven?
Oh, that's right. There were so many angels, they filled the entire night sky. And it was like nothing that the earth had ever seen before. A bright star lit up like a beacon, and the multitude, oh, they were in mighty proclamation mode, dancing, singing, and rejoicing, so much that the earth beneath the shepherds' feet began to rumble. The angels, they told the shepherds to go and see what God had done, for the Savior of mankind had been born, and a star would light their way. Now, where was I?
The angels!
The shepherds!
The baby Jesus!
Yes, the babe. Oh, the little boy who was born in that barn, he was just like any other lad, like you and like you. Well, except for the part about him being holy little boy and holy God. But he rocked in his mama's arms. He listened to her lullabies. He heard the lowing of the cows, and he heard the cooing of the doves in the rafters. He felt safe because his da was standing near.
Were there any other kids in the story?
Aye. Legend has it that one of the first visitors was a little boy with a very loud drum. Oh, at first the parents said, oh, no. Oh, but the baby Jesus, He thought it was brilliant. After all, nobody likes the banging of a drum better than a kid on Christmas Day. Sure that he would, but don't you want me to finish the story?
Yay!
Okay. Oh, let's see. Now, of all of the visitors who had come to see the baby Jesus, Mary and Joseph, they were probably most surprised by seeing three wise men from the east walk in, dressed as kings in silk and purple fabrics, wearing sparkling crowns on their heads. They knelt before the baby king. Oh, they brought him very expensive presents. Things that Joseph, he couldn't have afforded if he had worked an entire lifetime. Gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Now, do you remember? I said that Joseph would have to be very brave. He had just been warned by an angel that his family was in serious danger. There was an evil man named Herod who was jealous of the baby king. He wanted to murder the little boy because Herod, he loved power more than he loved God. He was searching everywhere for the young Jesus, and he would stop at nothing to find the boy and to kill him. But thankfully, the gifts from the wise men, they would help Joseph to buy safe passage into the land of Egypt, The small family, they would steal away into the night and escape the murderous tyrant Herod. But first, the wise men, they wanted to worship this newborn, Most High, King of all kings, Christ the Lord. Dad, you dear folk, Jesus didn't have to come to earth as a babe. He didn't have to know what it was like to be a lad with skinned knees. He didn't have to know what it was like to have brothers to share with, parents to obey, disappointments to overcome. He had to eat his vegetables. He had to learn how to walk. He kissed his auntie. And when he grew up, he He died on that cross to save the whole world.
Did he die for kids too?
Aye, he died for children too. The power of the story of the birth of Jesus is that he can be born in our hearts right now. His life, it can kindle life in us. So worship him with us, will you? Sing with us as we bow before our risen Savior, Jesus Christ the Lord. And if you haven't yet, give him your heart. It's the best Christmas present that you could ever give. Rejoice, rejoice! Our God is here with us. Now, Christmas is a time to celebrate, so we're going to do what the Irish love best, and we're going to have a party!
A birthday party for Jesus!
Oh, it's
that we love to hear. Oh, how I wish that every day was Christmas. What a nice way to spend a year. Oh, what a nice way to spend a year.
We're gonna have a party tonight. We're gonna have a party tonight. I'm gonna celebrate with Jesus, friends, and family, and do his birthday right.
It's the season of love and understanding. Merry Christmas, everyone.
Merry Christmas, everyone!
Tell you, I am so proud of all of these kids. So give it up for your kids one more time. You guys were amazing! Woo! Well, I have good news. If you need more of this, we are doing this again tomorrow at Cincy. So our choir will be performing at Cincy tomorrow. Our time slot is 6:45 to 7:15. So, and it's just the songs. There's no acting. But remember, when the kids sing, the devil says, I ain't got nothing. So come again tomorrow night if you guys want more. And really fast, guys, we just need to celebrate the reason that Kids Choir happens. And that is Pastor Frank and Betsy. Come on, get on up here. You cannot hide. Get up here. And if you didn't know, Betsy here wrote the script. So she is so talented. And then Pastor Frank is just a genius in getting these kids to perform. So you're incredible. We love you guys. Thank you for everything you do for the kids. All right, so we are going to dismiss the kids to go into the prayer room or the green room. And then that is where you guys will go to pick them up. So, you kiddos, follow your line leaders out. And then your mom or dad, just send back one person to pick them up. And that will make it go a little bit smoother.
Come on, amen. Can we thank Pastor Frank one more time? And these amazing kids, we are so proud of every single one of you. I say this every year, Pastor Frank, but this was the best one. But every year it gets better and better and better. You seriously amazing. Okay, I'm telling you, I don't think Disney has anything on this. Okay? I don't think anything in the world can, nothing can compete with this. Nothing can hold a candle. I mean, we had snow. We had real Irish dancers. Can we give it up for those Irish dancers? That was incredible. You've inspired me. I'm going to get my little floor into Irish dancing. Come on. The quads. I'm going to make it happen. But as Kelsey said, this couldn't happen without... It takes a lot to put on a production like this. I don't know if I'm allowed to say it, but something like this costs about $6,000 just to put on. And I know every week, I think back there and other times we've taken offerings, but we want to give one last chance. If you feel compelled tonight by the Holy Spirit, I believe we're going to have buckets in the back. Is that correct? So at the door as you're leaving, if you want to give something to this performance, because it's not only impacting our church, but it's going to impact thousands tomorrow. Is that correct? I think there's thousands of people that will be at the Sensi event tomorrow. So we want to give an opportunity tonight. Can we all give something, even if it's a dollar, whatever you have, let's give something. And one more time, can we thank Pastor Frank and Betsy and the team for all of their hard work and commitment and dedication? And of course, Jesus is the reason for all of this. I love Pastor Frank. I told him this yesterday, but he always keeps Jesus at the focus and the center for these kids. And that's why it's so anointed and powerful. And as Josh shared at the end, that this is all about Jesus. And the greatest gift you can do is give your heart to him this season. So if that's you, we have people that want to pray with you. If you were touched by this tonight and you want to maybe give your heart to Jesus or just have someone pray with you, I believe we're going to have people right over here. So please don't leave this place without getting that opportunity. One more time, let's thank Jesus for tonight. Amen. Thank you, Pastor Kelly. All right. Well, like those kids said, we are going to have a birthday party for Jesus. So out in the lobby, we will have free hot chocolate, lots and lots of cookies, and we will have the Irish dancers out there. Now, this is the, I hope I say this right, Anam Cara Irish Dance Academy. Yes, Irish Dance Academy. So go and watch them out there. Let them be your entertainment. And then in the gym, we have bounce houses. All your kids in their fanciest clothes just bouncing around after they have sugar and hot chocolate. So you're welcome. All right. Well, thank you all so much for coming. We will see you back if you want to. We have 3 Christmas Eve services, 1 o'clock, 3 o'clock, 5 o'clock. And then we have a 10 a.m. Christmas service on Christmas morning. So have a jolly good time.